you then, we're going to talk. Hello, Bears sports fans. Welcome to tonight's coverage of your boys lacrosse team facing the CBA Brothers. Tonight, it's a windy night here in Chenango, about 40 degrees out, and the game will be getting underway in about 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I'm here with Megan Pierce, member of the Bears ladies golf team right now, and she's going to be doing lacrosse for the first time. So, Megan, what do you think are the keys for the boys lacrosse team tonight to get the win?
Communication is always good, especially against a fast team like CBA. We really got to get our defense in lockdown. Hopefully we have a big senior to help out and get the back line communicating.
Sounds good. We will be back in about 2 minutes when this game gets underway. Thank you for joining us. Have a great night.
First quarter switch the earbuds with that. Here's, maybe it'll work for Sam.
Section 3 supports the goals of educationally sound competition and good sportsmanship in all contests. We ask that all spectators refrain from booing and other negative cheers and behavior and extend respect to the opponents, visitors, and officials. This evening's game is between the visiting Christian Brothers Academy Brothers and our hometown Chenango Bears. Would you please stand and remove your hat for the playing of our national anthem? Thank you. played tonight on www.nagotube.weebly.com.
And this game will start in just a couple seconds. Opening faceoff, Seth Spurgeon for the Bears. Lost it to number 3 for CBA. A couple of Bears were on the ground after that opening faceoff. That's something the Bears look to work on as the year progresses, winning more faceoffs, winning more offensive possessions.
Yeah, I'm sure when Christian Cereal comes back, he'll win a few for the team.
Opening shot by CBA off the pipe. That gets deflected out of bounds, but it will stay with the Brothers. Janago playing their man defense. CBA holds possession behind the goal. Little quick juke, and that ball gets poked away, and Carson Maciag ends up with it. Kicks over to Ryan Pitt, who will try to bring it up the sideline, and he clears it. So after about 2 opening possessions for the Brothers offense, the Bears, let's see what they can do on their first offensive attack. Cooper Young kicks over to Grant Zarnecki. Doesn't seem to be bothered by that Brothers poke check. Kicks over to Ryan Pitt. Tries a spin move and a high shot. That ball will sail over the goal out of bounds. Carl Farber is there. Penalty on the field, but it's delayed. Bears will continue, and that's a goal. I'll tell you who that is in 1 second after we see the number. Number 19, Seth Spurgeon, with the first goal tonight. So Bears 1-for-1 on their offensive possessions.
It's pretty good odds right there. Hopefully they win this faceoff and we can get another.
And as Megan just said, the second faceoff underway. Seth Spurgeon kicks it back. And the Bears retreat. And the defense gains possession. Looks like Joey Larini gets tripped up. Still a scramble for the ball. The refs blow play dead. And after the whistle, the Brothers will maintain possession. number 3, Alex Culkin, splits the two defenders, gets a shot off, but that's wide of the goal. Bears defense staying strong, opening this game.
Looks like the brothers are trying to set up a play to get a nice open shot off.
Cooper Young playing defense. Brother gets a shot off, and Carson Maciej gets a save, and this ball is sailing towards the out-of-bounds line. It will go out-of-bounds. CBA maintains possession. Loose ball right now. Won by CBA. And they will swing it around the perimeter, try to set something else up. Shot there by Cooper Young. And number 3, Alex Calkins, gets open and puts it in the top right corner. Tough one for Carson to try to save. So 8:51 left in the first quarter. Game's tied up 1-1. So the third face-off of the night. Ball gets free. Number 22, Billy Demand, won that for the Bears. He's having to step up and play face-off because, as Megan said earlier, Christian Cirio is out. Trevor Butler swings it to Grant Zarnecki. Grant trying to put a move on his defender, unable to shake loose. But Trevor Butler is. Gets a shot from behind, but he gets in towards the net. Swings it around, unable to corral the pass with Billy Demand. Carson with a nice save. May have gone off his shin. But CBA maintains possession. Gets in towards the crease. And number 7, Ben McCreary, scores for the brothers. With 7:54 left to go in the first.
Looks like Seth Spurgeon's going to take the face off instead of Billy Demand this time. Giving Billy a little break.
A couple juniors having to step up here for the Bears because, as Megan said earlier, Christian Cirio was a senior, is out. But this Bears team has quite a few juniors at start. Mr. Schwann will have a good lineup next year, hopefully a couple years after that too. And Seth won the faceoff. Loose ball kicks out to Cooper Young. He's trying to get around, breaks around his defender. And he'll pass it to Carl Farber, who will set up behind the net. Spurgeon sets up top, kicks to Cooper Young. Ball sails over the net on his shot. Gotta go to Carl Farber on the back line. Bottom of his stick gets hit and he loses possession. Deep hole for CBA. Came away with that one. And the brothers are on a fast break. Great ball movement there by the brothers. Gets a wide open shot. Number 7, Ben McCreary, for his second of the night.
At 6:52, we have 3-1. Brothers are winning.
Looks like this time it'll be sophomore Billy Demand with the face-off. staying still right now. Waiting for the ball to get kicked out. Called by the ref, and it will be Chenago ball. Billy DeMann going straight into his defender, even though he's given up some size. Kicks it to his big man, Grant Zarnecki. Gets in towards the crease, but gets pushed away. Tanner Laramie will swing it over. Trevor Butler swings it to Ryan Pitt. Ryan gets a shot off, but that looks like it got deflected off a CBA defender who looks to be a little shaken up on the play. So the Bears will set up another offensive attack. Bears doing what they usually do, swinging it around until they can get something open. That pass sails out of bounds from the Bears. Trying to swing it around. And they will retreat to the defensive side. Shot wide of the goal there for CBA, but they will retain possession. Pass across the crease for the brothers, unable to get a shot off there. Great, good defense right now. Loose ball. Seth Spurgeon fights for it, picks it up.
Let's hope the Bears get a score on this breakaway here. I need one.
Seth decides to pull away and pass out to Ryan Pitt, who will now set up over to Cooper Young. Looks like the brothers are playing man defense. Tanner Laramie was unable to corral the pass, and it gets scooped up by CBA. Of nifty moves there by one of the brothers. Ball ends up behind the net, and CBA will kick it out and look to set something up. Looks like one of the brothers shook himself to the ground, trying to put a move on.
Yeah.
Cooper Young puts a hit on one of the CBA attack. Good defense there by the Bears. And that ball looks to sail on the other side of midfield. It's popped up. Refs make a call, and it will go to the Bears. Spurgeon over to Young. An arid pass goes sails over his head. Grant Zarnecki unable to beat the ball out of bounds, and it will go back with the brothers. Brothers try to cross the ball through the middle of that defense, but it gets deflected down. Flag thrown. Brothers will have an attack. Shot saved there by Carson Maciag.
A few subs coming in for the Bears. Hopefully some fresh legs will help out our defense.
Thank you. refs trying to get everything organized, and play will resume in a minute. And here we go. Brothers swinging it around the perimeter. CBA on a power play right now. Loose ball on the pass. The scramble comes away. CBA ball. And that shot on goal and in the net for CBA. That was number 2, Patrick O'Brien for the Brothers, extending this lead to 4-1. 2:14 remaining in the first quarter. Face-off corralled by Cooper Young after that fight for the ball. Not an actual fight on the field. Trevor Butler puts a move on. Takes a shot that hits the pipe and sails out of bounds. That might have been an inch over the left. It might have been a goal. What do you think, Meg?
I think you're right, Brennan. I think the Bears are doing a great job on offense. I mean, they're getting the shots off. Some of them aren't going in. They'll fall.
Trevor Butler puts the same move on. A little deja vu, same type of shot. That one misses. Kyle Farber will fight for it. And he came up with a loose ball. Takes a shot because the goalie was out of the net. But that was wide. Mr. Schwann not happy with the call there, thinking Grant Zarnecki was closer to the ball. Nevertheless, it will be Brothers' ball, with about a minute remaining in the first. Couple big hits there by the Bears. Saved by Carson.
Let's hope the Bears can hold them for the last 48 seconds here till second quarter.
Great save by Carson Macy. Went to his knees, came up with the ball, kicks out to Cooper Young, who's already at midfield. Trying to sneak past the CBA defender. And Coach Schwann calls a timeout for the Bears. Momentum shift, it seemed, right there for the Bears. They went, got a nice save, and Carson kicked it out, and now they're on an offensive attack.
Yeah, they've got plenty of time to get a score before the quarter ends to make it 2-4, help us out a little bit.
And we will be back with the coverage after this timeout. after this timeout. We have roughly 26 seconds remaining. Ryan Pitt starts it up for the Bears. Swings it around to Grant Zarnecki. Swings it to Carl Farber. Runs around the net. Takes a fadeaway shot. That gets deflected. CBA player takes it up the sideline. It's on a full sprint. Takes a shot off. Ball gets deflected. Carson Masiak ran out of the goal as time expired. And that will end the first quarter of play. The score is 4-1, brothers up. And we will resume our coverage when the second quarter starts. The second quarter action's getting ready to begin. My co-commentator is getting back from her break, trying to get set up. And she made it before the opening whistle. Say hi to the fans, Meg.
Woo, let's go. Go Bears.
Spurgeon seems to have won the faceoff. Nope, ball's still loose. Scooped up by a CBA defender. CBA takes all the way down the field. Gets a quick shot off. Carson Masiak able to get the deflection. Save that ball from being put in the net. And CBA will retreat on their offensive attack. Number three for CBA gets loose. That's Alex Calkins. Loses his man. He gets an open shot on Carson Masiak. Would have been a tough save. So 40 seconds into the second quarter, CBA gets their fifth goal of the night. Billy Demand will try this face-off. Ball gets popped up and scooped away by a CBA midfielder. Thank you. CBA on the offensive attack. Player trying to make a couple quick moves. Shakes free of the defense. Gets a shot off, saved by Carson Masiag. Trevor Butler corrals the loose ball and starts heading upfield.
Let's hope the Bears can work it around here and get an open shot.
Trevor passes to Carl, passes to Tanner, who passes to Ryan, passes to Billy. Ball got loose, and CBA now with the fast break. Ryan Pitt catches up from behind and slows the break down. A couple quick passes there by CBA, and Carson Masiag gets another save.
Outlet pass to Cameron Tackley, who attempts to take it upfield.
He passes back to Carson. Carson pass to about midfield to Cooper Young. Cooper takes it around the net himself, passes back, attempts to pass back to Seth Spurgeon, unable to catch that one. Ball still loose. Grant Zarnecki fighting for it. Cooper Young comes and lays a big hit on Alex Calkins, and play is blown dead. CBA will have possession after that play. Alex Calkins with the ripper from about the 25-yard line. That was the lower left corner. Hard one for Carson to save. The CBA team has a plethora of players going to play college lacrosse, and by the looks of this game, I believe Alex Calkins may be one of them. Megan nods her head in agreement. Spurgeon lost a faceoff, but the ball sails out of bounds, and the possession will go to the Bears. Bill the man takes it for the Bears. Swings to Grant Zarnecki, who swings to Carl Farber, who puts a spin on. Loose ball scooped up by Coop. Coop with the scoop. Flag thrown. And Tanner Laramie almost had a wide open shot, but ball just a little too high. Play will be blown dead. I believe the Bears will have a power play.
Looks like Ryan Pitt will start with the ball about the 25-yard line.
The refs are getting together to discuss what is about to happen.
May have been some discrepancy there on that call.
Looks like they got everything sorted out. And play resumes. Bears have a man up, swinging it around, trying to get something open, trying to take advantage of their power play. Carl behind the net. Swings to Seth Spurgeon. Takes a shot. That will go wide of the net and go out of bounds.
Grant Zarnecki there to back it up, so it remains Chittenango ball.
Grant swings to Carl Farber behind the net.
Ryan Pitt with a great cut, but they just couldn't get the shot off.
Bears with a couple quick shots. See if they can't get one in the net.
CBA working real hard on defense here.
Grant Zarnecki with a good move. Ooh. And he finds the back of the net. He decided to take that one himself. Puts a couple moves on the defenders.
Looks good. Now we have a 2-6 game. Brothers are still up, but we have 7 minutes and 21 seconds left in the second quarter.
Plenty of time. Spurgeon with the face-off. Loose ball. Gets kicked out of bounds by Spurgeon. And that ball will go CBA's way. Loose ball off the pass. Scooped up by Ryan Pitt. Good move. Gets him past his defender. Carl Farber trying to do a shake and bake. Bears swinging it around like they usually do. Trevor Butler sneaks around the defender, takes a shot that gets saved. And CBA now on the attack. Number two, Zach Wilsey with the task of trying to guard Alex Calkins right now. But he gets the assist after passing number 14, Michael Eternato. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly, but he gets a goal. First for him of the night. And CBA, they answer back from the goal they just gave up.
Let's hope sophomore Billy DeMann can win this face-off so the Bears can reduce the lead that CBA has.
Some may say the deficit they've created for themselves.
Some may say that. Some may not.
Faceoff at a standstill right now. I think I may start calling Cooper Young the enforcer. He just came in and started hitting any jersey he could find. After that scramble for possession, CBA comes away with it. Calkins for the Brothers starts up about the 40-yard line. So we'll move on, and he finds the back of the net again tonight.
Is that 3 or 4 for Calkin right there?
Couldn't tell you. I'd have to push for the fourth goal. That's my guess.
I would agree, yeah. Kid's pretty good.
Calkins makes it 8-2 for the brothers.
The Bears are going to start to have to rally some points up here.
Face off won by Spurgeon, showing off his speed. Pass deflected and scooped up by CBA defender. CBA sets up an offense. Something we've seen a lot of tonight. Another shot there as number 35 for CBA falls to the ground after scoring a goal. Ryan McKenzie. So back-to-back goals for the brothers with 4:21 remaining in the second. 9-2 score. Bears looking to get some a momentum shift. A little change in M times V. These kids have been putting the FD in every day.
Yeah, that's a good work formula in physics, Brennan. Way to bring in your smarts to this fine evening and event.
This brother's offense, just swinging it around the perimeter. Shot wide than that. Quick spin move there by one of the brothers. Stick gets hit and loses possession. Ball still loose. Spurgeon spins away with it and heads upfield. Spurgeon takes a shot that gets saved by the CBA goalie. Tanner Laramie saves it from going out of bounds. Cooper, the enforcer, Young comes up with it. Pass to Carl Farber. Spins and nearly gets a shot.
Billy DeMann swinging it to Coop Young on the top.
Passes to Ryan Pitt. Ryan will set up this offense. Quick substitution for the Bears. Trevor Butler comes in. Carl with a quick spin. Coach Schwan calls another timeout in this first half with 2:23 remaining. Bears looking to cook something up for this offensive attack.
Hopefully he's got a good play in mind to get maybe a few scores, you know, before halftime.
Sounds good to me, and we will be back to see what happens after this timeout.
as the wind dies down here, Chittenango and CBA come back on the field. We got 2:23 left.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Sometimes people do that to you, Brennan.
Play resumes with Ryan Pitt taking it up the side. Good spin move, gets past the defense. Takes a shot. A bounce shot finds upper right corner. So Ryan Pitt on the scoreboard for Chittenango. That was a nice move.
Yeah, I liked it. Looked good.
He got a little bit more torque on that shot than the goalie was expecting. Bill Demand with the faceoff again tonight. Ball being kicked around until finally scooped up by CBA. The brother gets hit in the back.
Brothers kick it out to number 22 to get it worked around.
Alex Calkins knocks one player over, but the pass was a little mistake.
Willsey intercepted that, and the Bears looks like, oh, never mind, out of bounds. CBA will take the ball.
It's funny how a game can have a quick turn of events like that. Calkins takes it up the side for the brothers. They'll try working it around the perimeter with about a minute remaining in the first half. See if they can't score again. But hopefully the Bears defense shuts them down and possibly get a goal of their own. Cameron Tackley comes away with it. Loses it for the moment. Still fighting for it. No quit in any of these Bears players. Still chopping away. And sounds like the brothers will call a timeout with 29 seconds remaining in the first half. A lot of action going on right there. But
yeah, hopefully the Bears can hold them until halftime, and then they can come up with a good plan to come back with.
Sounds like a plan to me, Megan, and we will be back after this timeout.
Shout out to Coach Quintero up there in the booth, keeping scoring, playing some nice tunes.
Everybody's got a hungry heart. Even though the viewers at home couldn't hear that, I suggest you go look up Bruce Springsteen on YouTube during this halftime break, or stay tuned.
Shot by CBA goes out of bounds, and number 2 will bring it back in for CBA.
20 seconds left. CBA working around the perimeter. Gets a shot off, but Carson Maciej gets a save. 10 seconds left, and CBA calls another timeout. They're really trying to get one more goal before halftime. But hopefully this Bears defense will hold strong, and we will be back when the action resumes. Action about to resume.
8 seconds remaining here for the brothers.
Do a countdown. 3, 2, 1. I saw the net move, but I believe
know.
That it was not a goal. Time expired. So we will head into the halftime. Bears down 9-3. Hopefully Coach Swan can cook something up.
The Bears have to just keep rotating and moving the ball and then driving into the goal to try and score.
Sounds like a plan. We will be back when the third quarter resumes in about 6 minutes. Stay tuned. Welcome back, Bears fans, viewers. Action just resumed in the second half. Bears will start with the ball as Ryan Pitt brings it up the sideline. The wind doesn't seem to want to die down all the way yet, so it's still a little chilly here in Chenango. But we're on a sugar rush because we just ate Peep Oreos. What do you think of those, Megan?
I thought they were delicious. Some people say they're too sweet, but, you know, I really enjoyed them. Glass of milk with it would have been a little bit better, but overall, they were pretty delicious.
I can't tell if I'm shaking because of the cold or shaking because of the sugar rush right now. As we were talking about Peep Oreos, Cooper Young gets a shot off. The sail's out of bounds. Drop pass by Ryan Pitt. Turns into a CBA fast break. Number 22, Michael Matheson, for the Brothers, takes it up. And it looks like he may have a relative on the team, number 20, Joey Matheson.
But you think they're brothers, Brennan, or cousins, or?
They could have no relation. We will never know.
Very true. Very true. Well, never know these days.
We could ask him after the game.
Could. Little interview on the field after the game.
You think Matheson is a common name?
Yeah, I believe it is.
I'll tell you, it's not a basic last name like we had a couple weeks ago, last week. Basic brothers or cousins or just basic last name. That shot bounced up and hit the top pipe, but did not fall for the Brothers.
As they recover, we got a long pull, number 5, that took it up for the Brothers.
And CBA will slow down their offensive attack. Get a quick substitution in. And they'll try to set something up. Pass across the crease. It was a great pass right on target to number 8 for the Brothers, who puts it in the back of the net. That was a tough one for Carson to save because it was one-on-one from about 3 feet away.
Yeah, it's never good when they get the crossover pass across the goal because then there's nobody there because the defense has shifted over. Can't shift over quick enough to help out Carson.
I was going to try to pronounce the name of the brother that got the goal, but I'm just not going to.
Well, he did a good job. We'll give him props.
Number 8.
Good job, number 8.
Number 8 extended the score to 10-3. CBA won the faceoff. Great save by Carson. He's had quite a few saves tonight. Gets another one there. 2 in a row. Helping the stats.
Outlet pass to Billy DeMann, who's getting it over half field. Hopefully the Bears can work it around and get a score right here.
Grant Zarnecki starts with the ball. Drops it. But it doesn't matter. Oh, dropped it again.
A little scramble.
That ball will stay with the Bears.
Grant Zarnecki working his defender.
Still with it, but just now gave it up to fellow teammate Carl Farber, who works a double team.
But hit the top post there, Brennan. Pretty close.
And the goalie for CBA comes up with it.
CBA works it upfield.
One of the Matheson Brothers has possession.
Or Cousins.
No, I'm saying CBA Brothers.
Oh, I gotcha. Very funny, Brennan.
But he could be a CBA brother, Matheson brother.
Ah, tricky.
A double brother. Tricky. The Moose would have a hard time figuring that one out.
Yeah, we need the wise owl to solve that one.
Hopefully Mr. Clancy's tuned in, can hear what we're talking about. Shot wide of the net. Carson trying to show off his wheels, falls to the ground. As we've seen a lot earlier this year, Carson has quite a bit of speed to him, wins a lot of those breaks to the ball. I could say he might be the fastest goalie in the state.
Yeah, I definitely think Carson Maziak's really improved since last year. He's stepped it up as a senior to be a good goalie for this team.
Most definitely. The Bears win possession after the ball sails out of bounds. Trevor Butler able to corral the ball at midfield, but gets hit in the back and forced to the ground.
Lost his stick on that play.
Flag was thrown. Not sure exactly what happened. Doesn't seem like either coach is happy with the officiating in the past couple minutes.
Got some subs coming in for both the Brothers and the Bears.
The Brothers may have a power play right here. It looks like it'll be that way.
Bears got to pack the defense in and make sure the Brothers can't get an open shot here.
The Brothers lose the ball, goes out of bounds. Cameron Tagley made a great defensive effort. And Spurgeon will start with the ball. Spurgeon attempts to do a spin, but the ball got hit out of bounds. I believe the CBA coach wants to know what in the world one of his players is doing, but.
Yeah, sometimes you just don't know. Everybody's got a different mind.
Nevertheless, CBA will retain possession.
As Mr. Clancy would say, you know, you gotta see the forest through the trees.
That's true. Carson Maciag with an impressive save. Might have been Carson, or just got deflected. We'll give it to Carson. Alex Culkin showing off his defense, but a mistake on his pass as he turns it over. Cooper Young taking it up for the Bears. Pass over to Trevor Butler. Drops
it. Penetrating kick there.
Play blown dead. Very enthusiastic coach on the CBA side. He loves cheering on these refs. And that is a goal from CBA as number 7, Ben McCreary, gets in towards the crease and gets an open shot on Carson Maciag. Oh, I believe McCreary is a name that we've called a couple times tonight, right next to Culkins.
Yeah, now we have a 11-3. Brothers are up. Hopefully the Bears can start rallying up some goals.
like that the sun just came out.
Yeah, it's very nice in Chittenango at the moment when the wind dies down.
Nice,
it's pretty warm.
Speaking of the wind, there it is.
Maybe we jinxed it, Brennan.
Possibly. Well, CBA just won that face-off. And they're doing what they've been doing all night. Swinging around the perimeter to set up an offense. And that's another goal back-to-back. I believe that was Alex Calkins.
I believe it was, Brennan.
That's another one for him on the night.
Very skilled player. He took that shot from outside and looked good.
I think all the shots have been taken from outside.
You could be right.
I believe they only play indoor lacrosse when there's snow on the ground. So back-to-back goals for the brothers. But Spurgeon answers with a face-off win. A bounce pass to his teammate, Cooper Young. Carl Farber around the back of the net. And Spurgeon will set up for the Bears. Gets past a teammate, or not a teammate, pardon me, a defender. As his teammate tries to win the ball back, Carl Farber does that. Carl sneaks past the defense, takes a shot. It goes wide. But Trevor Butler there. Play resumes. Trevor passes to Cooper, who lobs it over to Bill Demand, who takes a shot that's nearly on target.
Looks like it maybe bounced off the goalie's foot. I'm not sure, though.
The ref just made a call that, not sure what he just called. Was unable to see the signal, but CBA will have the ball now. The goalie's going to walk it up for the brothers. Kicks it out to the side, swings it up. Bill Demand playing defense, unable to stop the goal by number 22, Michael Matheson. That's a brother goal. Extending this lead to 10, score of 13-3, with 2:47 remaining in the third quarter.
Bears have really got to pick it up in order to win this game.
And we'll see Spurgeon with the face-off again. Pokes it out. Unable to scoop it up, though. Cooper, the enforcer, Young, looks like he's tied up with someone.
A penalty on Chittenango, and ball goes to CBA.
Set of quick passes by the brothers.
Cooper Young takes a stick right out of number 20's hand from CBA, and Chittenango wins the ball.
Spurgeon Spurgeon on the attack. Takes a shot that gets saved by the CBA goalie. Well, a lot just happened right there, but the outcome was that CBA worked the ball all the way up on the offensive attack. But now the Bears have the ball. Trevor Butler takes it up. Passes over to his teammate, Carl Farber. To Cooper Young, cutting across, and Cooper gets the goal.
There we go, nice play by Chitinango.
Coop gets a goal on the run with 1:17 remaining in the third. A couple more of those, we'll have quite a game on our hands.
Yeah, we've definitely built up our M times V, and hopefully we can keep it going.
Megan showing her smarts with the physics talk. Bill Demand with the face-off. Coop with... Cooper Young almost came up with it. As Alex Calkins takes a shot that gets saved by Carson Maciag.
CBA with numbers there, but still got the save.
Carson quickly throws it out to Cooper, who throws it upfield to Billy Demand. Ball gets popped way up in the air by the CBA goalie. A lot of scrambling going on right now. CBA able to get it on their side of the field. Ryan Pitt
takes a tumble.
And Carson made another great save. Yeah, Ryan chopped at the CBA attackman, but managed to trip himself. But with nearly 25 seconds remaining, the timeout was called. A lot of action going on. 13-4 score. We will be back when the play resumes.
As we come back, Coach C was playing a little CCR in that timeout.
Meg, have you ever seen the rain?
I have. Good thing it's not raining today.
That's an added bonus to doing this awesome broadcast job. Carson takes a shot off, hopefully a pad, or else that's going to leave a mark. And time expires. So Bears able to hold off CBA in the remaining 30 seconds. and the score was 13-4. Coming in on the last 12 minutes of play when we return. And we are back for the final quarter of play tonight. That is Seth Spurgeon with the faceoff.
Well, the Bears got 12 minutes to get a lead on the CBA brothers here.
CBA with the first possession of the quarter.
They're working it around.
Brothers still just working around, trying to get something open. Number 25 tries to get some penetration, and a flag was thrown.
Ugh. Number 20 with that goal. Brennan, who's that?
That is Joey Matheson.
Ah, one of the brothers.
Well, they're all brothers, Megan. They play for CBA.
Ah, true. Can't decipher who's who in this game. Brothers bringing their lead back up to 10.
What brothers? Joey and Michael Matheson brothers or the
CBA
brothers?
The CBA brothers as an overall. Gotcha. There. Team, united team.
Well, CBA trying to win this faceoff. They do, and now they are man up because of the delayed penalty. Alex Calkins just standing around with the ball waiting for some offensive movement. CBA working around, and another shot, back-to-back goals, number 35, Ryan McKenzie.
Ripped up to the top shelf there.
Right where Mama keeps the cookie jar, the top shelf.
Gotta love Mama's cookies.
I don't know what to say to that comment, Megan. Well, Bill DeMand will try this face off. As Coop, the enforcer, Young gets the scoop. I got too many nicknames for him. Coop with the scoop.
Grant Zarnecki working the defense.
Looks like Grant might have been in the crease. Yep. Good call, Megan. Well, CBA went from one end to the other before losing the ball. Cameron Tackley tried to scoop it up, but unable to do so. Ball goes out of bounds. And Chenago will win possession, and Billy DeMann will start it up.
Long pass up to Seth.
Bears trying to set something up. The CBA tries to put some pressure on to force Chenango to do something.
Ryan Pitt re-entering the game. Hopefully set something up.
Bears looking to get some movement here. Ryan signaling to his teammate, Carl Farber, who makes a move, fights off a double team, loses the ball, and CBA going for a fast break. Good defense there by Spurgeon forces CBA to retreat in their offensive attack, and now they'll just work the ball around the perimeter.
Seth did a great job there stopping the ball on the break. That's what you have to do, otherwise they usually get the open shot.
Something you learn in basketball too, Meg.
I'm aware.
Roughly 8 minutes remaining. 15-4 is the score. Ball flipped over the net. And Jake Graham will come away with it. Up to Ryan Pitt, who races towards the other end of the field. Bill DeMann to Grant Zarnecki to Carl Farber, who puts this nice spin move on, takes a shot.
It's wide right, and Grant scrambles for the ball. Ooh, scooped it right in.
That was like a golf shot. I'll go to the expert golfer in Megan Pierce now. What do you think of that form Grant just had on that shot?
That was pretty good. I mean, lacrosse stick versus golf club, a little different. But the he definitely did a great job kicking that in.
So, after that goal, score is 15-5. With 7:30 remaining. Spurgeon still fighting for the ball, but CBA will come away with that faceoff.
CBA slowing it down here to set a play up. Like there's a screen up top. Seth,
looked like CBA took a shot, but he lost the ball. As Spurgeon races up the field. Quick dump off to Carl Farber.
Carl snags it off the bounce to keep it in bounds.
Then kicks over to Trevor Butler, who swings it around. Finds his way back to Carl Farber, who takes a shot from about the 20-yard line and found the back of the net. So, back-to-back goals for the Bears. Only down 9 now, 15-6, with 6 minutes, 18 seconds remaining. And you never know.
Yeah, a lot of damage can be done in 6 minutes in a lacrosse game. You never know. Each face-off won is another step closer.
Bill Demand trying to win this face-off for the Bears. And it looks like the sophomore Billy Demand comes away with it. Bears getting a little bit more M times V.
Better bring physics into it, Brennan. Physics is always in the real world.
Trevor Butler coming off the screen set by teammate Carl Farber.
Billy falling on his shot, but makes it in.
That ball trickled, and the goalie just looked down and saw it in the net. Didn't even see the net move. The CBA coach does not seem to be thrilled by the events that have just taken place after 3 goals by the Bears.
I'm guessing Mr. Schwann must have given these boys some good advice during the third quarter, or after the third quarter, in between the third and fourth. They definitely got the momentum up.
Face-off won by the brothers. Everything going the Bears' way right now. The ball sails out of bounds. Cooper Young will start it up for the Bears. Makes it past one brother, past another brother, past a third brother, past a fourth, past a fifth. Takes a shot, and just wide of the goal. That would have been cool if he made it.
It would have. That was a very good run by the enforcer, Cooper Young.
Past the entire team, I should say. The refs stop play momentarily.
Looks like the CBA coach isn't too happy about some of these calls, but Chinango will keep the ball.
He politely asked what the call was.
With an enthusiastic tone.
Grant Zarnacki trying to put a move on the defender, get something going. Spurgeon trying to do the same. Defender falls. Poked away. And what happened there was the CBA goalie came out of the net and stuffed the shot by, I believe, Billy Demand.
I didn't see the number. I'd just say a fellow Bear.
Stuffed the shot and got the ball away for CBA.
CBA working it around, hoping they can get their lead back up.
They're retreating on the offensive attack. Saved by, or I don't know if it was saved, but the ball got deflected, possibly by Carson. and Cameron Tackley came away with it. He's getting swarmed by two brothers. Well, I believe Coach Schwann was trying to call for a timeout. I don't know if the refs awarded it to him in time. Quite a bit of excitement by the CBA sideline.
Got a switch of goalies here. Carson's going to be taken out, and I believe Corey Fredericks is going in, another senior.
All right, so Coach Schwann was awarded the timeout. Yeah, a lot of confusion right there.
Yeah, I guess he's taking the timeout, but I think we're just doing subs maybe, and we're leaving everybody in. So who knows? I mean, we've got 3:36 to go. A lot could happen.
Agreed.
I think CBA is starting with the ball here, so the Bears will be on defense.
And the ref. Whistle. Has not blown the whistle to start this again? Not really sure. Okay, there we go.
There we go, yeah. Starting back up.
Number four takes a shot over the net. There we go. Back on track. And CBA will retain possession. CBA is just going to swing it around, try to probably take as much time off the clock as they can. As they have a 15-7 lead with just over 3 minutes remaining in the final quarter of play.
Nice switch there on top from the screen by the Bears.
CBA still working the ball around. And they get it to number 18 in the crease and gets a shot past Corey Fredericks. That is Zach Eber with the goal.
Yeah, 18 just cut right to the middle, and nobody picked him up, so he's open. Granted, he is also pretty tall, makes it a little easier. Turn and shot.
So it looked like Zach Eber had Corey Fredericks' number there. They're both 18.
Very true, very true. Billy DeMann in the face-off. Looks like CBA, or nope, Zach Wilsey's got it. Oh, never mind, scrambling for the ball.
Billy DeMann ends up scooping it up. Over to Grant Zarnecki. Swings it to Ryan Pitt, but that ball pops in the air, and I believe he lost sight of it. Taps it away. Out to Trevor Butler. Went to take a shot, but the ball got hit. Ball still loose. Not sure who has it. No one yet. Oh, now to CBA. Okay. Number 18, who dumps it down.
Corey came out there, right decision, but just went right over his head.
Another CBA goal. So two quick ones past minute.
CBA's lead back up to 10 with 2:07 remaining.
So we got Spurgeon with the face-off. He popped it up, but lost sight of it. Didn't know where the ball went.
Ball Bears defense is just fighting to finish strong in this game tonight.
Another goal. Ball gets past Corey Fredericks. Number 13 for CBA there.
So looks like the man marking as well, but we need a little more help defense, I think.
A few quick ones towards the end of this fourth quarter. Well, since we have a little stop of play, I'd like to thank everyone helping with this broadcast tonight. We have Sam Hill, as well as Mr. Cortero in the booth, working with Lauren Hardy and Hannah Butler, the wonderful Mrs. Karp, working the camera, as always, out here in the windy, no matter what weather, and my co-anchor, Megan Pierce, and I.
Yeah, Brian, done a great job tonight.
You too, Megan. It's always fun. You're out here supporting Bears sports.
Hey, at least the sun's out, you know? Cooper attempts a shot there, but CBA takes the ball away.
Another pass to 18. Ball sails out of bounds.
Looks like we may have a hurt bear on the field here.
That's nothing that you don't ever want to see that.
It's not good. I'm not sure who's down, but we're all hoping he'll be all right.
Like it may be Ryan Pitt.
Looks like they're going to give him some space and check it out.
Wow, hopefully this injured player will be all right. We'll take a short break and come right back. Ryan Pitt able to get up and looks he's limping off the field under his own power, so that's a good sign.
Hopefully Ryan will be back for next game. The Bears need him. He's vital for the team.
Hopefully he's just healthy. It's never anything you want to see, especially with just over a minute remaining in the fourth quarter after being down 11. CBA will continue on the attack.
Number four for CBA hitting the top corner of the post. Ball going out of bounds to Chitnango.
Spurgeon taking it up the field. Now in the final minute of this game. Maybe the Bears can get another goal.
They'll work it around and hopefully somebody. Oh, we got a screen on top by Seth.
Finding that to Grant. Out to Carl. I believe that's Mark Dang in the game. Nearly with the goal.
Zach Wilsey taking the ball up. Mark, Speed Demon.
Mark Dang setting himself in the crease.
Yeah, both teams fighting for the ball here, and looks like, think the Bears will keep the ball here.
Ball is out of bounds. 4 seconds to go. Maybe Mark Dang can score.
Little last minute goal. Or last second, I should say.
Nope, the Bears will hold it. And time expires.
So we have a 18-7 game. The CBA brothers took the win on this one.
Well, it was a hard-fought game. Glad we got to be out here broadcast it. Hopefully the Bears can get a win their next game.
Yeah, they definitely learn from every win and loss. And I think they'll improve and keep improving throughout the season because it's early yet.
Definitely. Thanks to everyone who viewed at home. Thanks for everyone helping with the broadcast. And please tune in on Saturday. We'll be at OCC covering both the baseball and softball Bears sports. Thank you very much, and we are out.